Jeremy Sockman here today with a look at a movie that you might think is French, but once you get past the title, you'll find out it's the King's English all the way. It's Monsieur Beaucaire from 1946, starring Bob Hope. This one's speaking more than just the King's language, it's also spreading his ideas. So let's take a look. King Louis XV of France is given the chance to avert a war with Spain by marrying one of his nobles to King Philip's daughter. He knows just the right man, Duke Lachandra. Seems like the ladies already like him, and he'd be better out of the king's hair. Meanwhile, the titular Monsieur Beaucaire is the king's barber, and longs for the scullery maid Mimi, who longs for the king. When Beaucaire gets a little mixed up wearing the king's clothes and helping Lachandra hide someone's wife under a blanket, he's locked up and given the sentence of death by beheading.
Chop off his head tonight!
This'll teach me a lesson. What a way to die.
Be brave, my friend. You wanted to go anyway.
But like a man, not like a salami.
Of course, Lachandra helps him escape, and the two head off to Spain in each other's clothes. Along the way, they save two women in peril, coincidentally the princess. And she and the Duke fall in love. One problem, everyone thinks Beaucaire is him. As General Don Francisco plots to kill the Duke and prevent the marriage, Beaucaire manages to stay whole free, avoid drinking acid, and barely dodges marrying the princess when the real Duke reveals himself and, spoiler alert, saves the day. Then Beaucaire, Mimi, and Don Francisco flee to America to start a barbershop.
Something special going on today, Mr. Washington?
Oh, Jefferson and the boys are cooking up some sort of a declaration or something. I thought I might go and watch them sign it.
Now, it's easy to get distracted by the powdered wigs and flowy costumes of Mr. Beaucaire and miss the point that the director George Marshall was trying to sneak by. You see, this is a story about how the status of your birth determines your worth. Beaucaire is a commoner. He has a big nose, no money, and no girl. Sure, he has a good job, but he's pretty awful at it, and was on his way to having no head too. Au contraire, we have Duke Lachandra, who has a regular-sized nose, lots of cash, lots of ladies, is the best sword fighter in the land, has a great singing voice, natural charm and charisma, and you see where I'm going with this. We're reminded time and time again that he's noble-born and bred, and therefore better. Maybe we could dismiss that if he was the bumbling fool of the story, but that's Beaucaire. Lachandra is forced to save the man's life again and again and again, and if he's not around, then inanimate musical instruments step in. Beaucaire embarrasses himself at court, doesn't know etiquette, and was on his way to another death sentence until he fled the continent. It doesn't take noble birth to see that someone behind this story was really into pedigree and breeding.
But your speech, your swordsmanship, your bearing, it's more fitting one of gentle, even of royal birth.
So in the end, by having the commoner be the idiot and the nobleman be the true hero, Monsieur Beaucaire wants to reinforce that whole divine right nonsense that I thought we'd evolve past back when movies were still in black and white. Guess I was wrong. So that's why I'm Jeremy Sockman, and I'm giving the anti-common people hoity-toity nose-looking-down movie that is Monsieur Beaucaire a hard pass.
Now listen closely.
I'm listening.
One of us is a duke and one of us is a barber, right?
Right.
But they don't know which is which.
Oh, the morons.
If we change clothes now and they kill me, what have they got?
The duke.
But if we stay the way we are and let them kill you, what have they got?
Nothing but a barber.
I knew you'd see it.
We stay the way we are.
Good man. Vive le duke.
Vive le duke.
See you in Madrid.
And good luck. Say, the duke's a pretty smart fellow to figure a thing like that out. Now all they're gonna kill is a crummy little barber. A barber, that's me!
Long live the duke.
Long live the duke!
He'll never live like common people. He'll never do whatever common people do. You'll never fail like common people. You'll never watch your life slide out of you and dance and drink and screw. Cause there's nothing else to do.